السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. درس بك برادرز من الله سبحانه وتعالى اقسمت والصلاة. أم أسمد الله عز وجل واكسبت والفور جود ديدز أمين يا أرحم الراحمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين وجست فيني صلاة الفجر الجماعة. It's a great blessing from الله سبحانه وتعالى. And this is like what الله سبحانه وتعالى said. ذلك الفوز العظيم. ذلك الفوز العظيم. This is the really supreme success in dunya and the akhirah. When you start your day with salah and you are in right track with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah At-Tawbah, verse number 72, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. مش كده وبس. Let's continue the ayah. ومساكن طيبة في جنات عدن. مش كده وبس. Wait, لسه. ورضوان من الله أكبر. مش كده لسه. ذلك الفوز وذلك هو الفوز العظيم. وذلك هو الفوز العظيم. خلينا نفهم بقى شوي القرآن يعني. خلينا نفهم القرآن شوي. الله سبحانه وتعالى in this verse number 72 in سورة التوبة he said وعد الله المؤمنين والمؤمنات. الله سبحانه وتعالى did promise the believing men and the believing women with what? Jannat. Jannat, paradise. Jannat, tajri, which underneath rivers flow. Tajri min tahta al-anhar, khalidina fiha forever. But see, mas'alti al-wa'ad, the promise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, if you understand the whole entire Quran together, it comes here. Don't take one ayah and say, I understand the Quran. You don't understand nothing. You have to read too many ayat and you have to connect this ayah, the meaning with this ayah, with that ayah. You connect it together and get the full picture. This is exactly the interpretation of the Quran. Otherwise, you will never understand it. Plus the grammar, plus the Arabic, plus tafsir, plus you have to study the science of the Quran to get all the picture. Otherwise, just you read. You read, you don't know. Yeah. See, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the promise, the wa'ad, in the Holy Quran. Wa'ad Allah. Wa'ad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has something in the Quran called wa'ad wa wa'id. Wa'ad for the mu'mineen, wa'id for the kafirin. Wa'ad with jannah, wa'id for the punishment. يبقى الثواب والعقاب. مسألة الثواب والعقاب. The reward and the punishment. The one, like in our life, if you see somebody like a student, we're telling you have two students. We're telling both of them, you study hard, you do your job, do it good, and in the end of the year, you're gonna have the test and you're gonna pass your exam. One of them was following the construction. He was doing everything. He studied, he was struggling, striving, doing everything. And mashallah, he came and he passed it. Another one was playing, enjoying. The same thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, stealing us to many ayat in the Holy Quran, أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ. Do you think the Muslim and the criminal will be the same in the sight of Allah? No. أَمْ نَجْعَلُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَالْمُفْسِدِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَمْ نَجْعَلُ الْمُتَّقِينَ كَالْفُجَّارِ. Do you think those who used to believe and they used to make righteous good deeds, they're going to be equal in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like those who are making mischief on the earth? And the fajr going to be like the pious? They will never be equal in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who started his day with Salat al-Fajr like you, mashallah. And Allah in your heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in your heart. And you start your day with ibadah, being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're trying to do your best. Like somebody making mischief on the earth. Somebody just sleeping, snoring, and you see him all the time. Mashallah, his cousin with the shaitan. ودي الشيطان ولاد عم الاثنين قاعدين ماشيين مع بعض 24 ساعة 24/7. Do you think they're gonna be equal? No. That's why Allah said وعدا. And this ayah comes between ايه؟ The ayah in Surah At-Tawbah and the chapter of At-Tawbah. And Surah At-Tawbah مدنية صح؟ Talks about the منافق, about too many things. فالسورة talks about the كافر and the منافق. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى already he promised them with the punishment. And you look to the verse number 72 comes in the middle. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no. But I'm going to deal in different way with the mu'mineen and the mu'minat. And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the male and the female in the ayah? Because women and men, they are equal. Sister, don't be happy. Equal in thawb al-iqab, not in dunya. Aywa. Aywa, don't be happy. Male, the rooster is a rooster and the chicken is a chicken. Allah said that in the Quran. Means, وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. The male will never be like a female. I'm not trying to put you down, no. Allah created you in different feature, and He created the man in different feature. And the act like what Allah created you. If you are a woman, you have to be a woman, a female. Huh? You see nowadays some boys, we see the girl, she's acting like a man. And this is creepy. And sometimes you see some men also very happy, mashallah. Very happy men, you know? They are happy. Baskut al akhir, baskawit. This kind of what kind of man this? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Wa'ad Allahu al-mu'minina wal-mu'minat. Allah did promise the believing men and the believing women in the thawab al-iqab, the reward and the punishment, men and women equal. Sister, if you're not praying, your husband will not go to hellfire for you. Maybe he will be in hell for you in this dunya, working hard to give you food and taking care of you, but nobody gonna take care of you there, sister. If you're not praying, if you're not doing your job, if Wallahi al-Azim, that sister in Texas, I will never forget her. She said, Sheikh, I'm happy. Say, what sister in the phone? I was in my office in Masjid Dar al-Iman in Arlington. That's 2003. And she said, why sister? MashaAllah, you're happy. Alhamdulillah, good. She said, Alhamdulillah, my husband is praying for me. I'm not praying. Alhamdulillah. He's doing a good job. I tell her, inshallah, your husband is carrying you to the hellfire. You have to work. You have to pray for your own self. Your husband cannot pray for you. For that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the promise to the men and the women, the believing women and the believing men. With what? With Jannat. Jannah in Arabic, if you look at the Jannah, Jannah comes from the word, the definition of the word. Jannah, Jinn, see? Same sound, right? Jannah means Jannah, paradise. Jinn means the Jinn. What is the relationship between Jannah and Jinn? Or Jannat? Huh? No, there's something hidden. Something hidden. Did you see the Jannah? No. Did you see the Jinn? No. فجنة وجنة وجنة عليه الليل. All of this comes from the definition of the word in Arabic. جنة جيم نون means hidden, something hidden. You did not see it yet. جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار. Another ayat said تجري تحتها الأنهار. The source of the water comes from جنة itself. And the water in جنة and the rivers will go without a shot. Shot اللي هو ايه؟
البانك.
الشطوط. شط.
Shore.
What is this?
S-H-O-R-E.
Okay. Shore. اللي هو الشط يعني؟
Yeah.
طيب. اللي يبقى الجنان and the rivers in Jannah will run without shores. Right? There is no shutut or something to hold it. Who created the Jannah? Allah. Who created the heaven? Did you see any pillars carrying this heaven, the sky or heaven? No. Allah سبحانه وتعالى capable. You're going to see that the river of Al-Khamr was coming, mixed with the, not mixed. It's running beside the river of the milk, the river of the water, the river of oil, and never gonna be mixed. Even that happened in dunya, and Allah mentioned that in Surah Ar-Rahman, just to let you understand Allah's capable. In Jannah, gonna make more than that. هي مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان. You see the two oceans, they are hitting each other, but this salty water and this sweet water. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, between them barzakh, a barrier, subhanAllah. In Jannah, the same thing, no shores, rivers are flowing, running, and they will never mix. Allahu Akbar, subhanAllah. Why in Jannah? Who created the Jannah for you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خالدين فيها. خالدين فيها في آية قالت فأما الذين سعدوا ففي الجنة خالدين فيها ما دامت السماوات والأرض. هذا ما كنت لونج أبو محمود. فأما الذين سعدوا ففي الجنة خالدين فيها ما دامت السماوات والأرض. طب ربنا قال برضو ان الكفار خالدين فيها ما دامت السماوات والارض. لا. الله سبحانه وتعالى said those will be happy and they will go to Jannah. They're gonna stay in Jannah for eternity or forever. While the heaven and the earth is still remaining, it means if there is the heaven and the earth will not be destroyed, they're gonna stay in Jannah. What about if Allah destroyed the heaven and the earth? They will get out of Jannah? Allah is talking about this heaven and the earth or the heaven and the earth there? He's talking about the heaven and the earth there, not here. This heaven and the earth is for المعاش. But the heaven and the earth there for المعاد. يوم تبدل الأرض والأرض غير الإيه؟ السماوات. If the hereafter, the heaven and the earth will remain forever, means the mu'min gonna remain in Jannah forever. ما دامت السماوات والأرض. This is the understanding of the ayah. So we have to understand from the ayah, this is the trick of the Quran. The trick of the Quran, you have to study it. The heaven and the earth is not talking about this heaven and the earth. It's talking about heaven and the earth there. Because this heaven and the earth will be destroyed. Allah will replace it with another. The ayah said that in Surah Zumar. يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات وبرزوا لله الواحد القهار. فديس آيات. فالله سبحانه وتعالى سيد جنات تجري من تحت خالدين فيها ومساكن طيبة. What's مساكن؟ مساكن mansions. Allah will create mansions for you in Jannah. Not just الجنة. الجنة this is very wide and big land full of trees and all of that. This is the Jannah. Even if you go inside the Dura, you said the sugar cane, what happened? You hide yourself. فالجنة has a lot of trees. You can go inside. You can hide yourself. That's called Jannah. Something hidden. And the Jannah, ربنا بيقولها على الايه؟ any garden or anything in this dunya, we call it Jannah too. أصحاب الجنتين صح؟ صاحب الجنتين في سورة الكهف. فمسألة الثواب والعقاب مهمة جدا. الثواب the punishment and the reward. Like ذو القرنين. قال في سورة الكهف. فأما الذين آمنوا وعملوا فله جزاء الحسنى. ويعني فذو القرنين قال ايه؟ احنا we're gonna punish those who are bad and we're gonna reward those who are good. فمسألة الثواب والعقاب مهمة جدا. Don't think الله سبحانه وتعالى created us like that. أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبثا؟ You think Allah created you like just for playing or amusement? No. مسألة الثواب والعقاب. You make good, you get good. You can make bad, you're gonna get bad. This is the way Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
فمن يمشي مكبا.
أيوة نعم. فأما من يمشي على الصراط المستقيم دنيا ده آخرة. That's right. If somebody in the straight path, he's not equal to somebody he don't know how to walk. Yeah. The point here is Allah سبحانه وتعالى said ومساكن طيبة في جنات عدن. مساكن mentions Allah prepared it for us. You enjoy in Jannah and you come in the end for your privacy. The حور عين بقى شيخ محمد و enjoy your مساكن. Your dwellings, you know, you're gonna dwell in it, in this مساكن طيب.
Is Blimpy also in there?
That's everything free. There's no, don't worry about Blimbling. It's free, خلاص. Actually, to be honest, it's a big Blimbling. صلاة الفجر, it's a price now. Yes, whatever you're doing today, this is a price for there. Nothing free. الله سبحانه وتعالى منشن ذات أن الرسول سيد ذات الحديث ألا إن سلعة الله غالية ألا إن سلعة الله الجنة. الجنة is not free. If somebody saying الجنة is free, he's مسكين. سلعة الله الجنة غالية. It's very expensive. It's not cheap.
You have to pay for it.
This is what you are doing now. You are paying for it now. When you come to the Salah, you stand in rows, you wake up for صلاة الفجر. This cold weather, this is the price of Jannah. Nothing free. فقال لك ومساكن طيبة beautiful mentions in جنات عدن. What is جنات عدن? What is عدن mean? في عدن في اليمن. But احنا عدن is Eden. They call it in English. Eden. It is not. عدن means الإقامة in Arabic. عين دال نون means عدنا يعني أقام. This is in Arabic language. The definition of the word عدنا means أقام. يعني أقام he stay or he dwell in that place. This is called جنات عدن. And Allah name it for you. يعني he give you the address. يعني you will not miss it. جنات عدن, you know where you're going. That's why he says in Surah Muhammad, أدخلهم الجنة عرفها لهم. When you go to your Jannah, you don't need any guide there. You're gonna see it for first time as if you live there for millions of years. You're gonna know this way, this room, as if you've been there for a long time. Allah said عرفها لهم in the Quran. وأدخلهم الجنة عرفها لهم. You didn't need guide, you didn't need anybody to tell you where to go and all of that stuff. And I don't want to make it long. He said, Jannat Adnin, Khalid, طبعاً, you're going to stay forever there. If you go to Jannah, nobody can kick you out, of course. But somebody, Muslims, will go to hellfire, of course. يعني, like Sheikh Muhammad said in his way, the mechanic shop, يعني, body shop, he must be fixed a little bit. Yes, of course. Some sin, he must be purified. I will go to Jannah later. Yeah. But if you go to Jannah, nobody can kick you out. خلاص, that's it. خلاص. Would you like to go to out of Jannah? If somebody go to Jannah, he cannot be out. That's it. But if somebody go to hellfire from the Muslims, somehow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive them and they will be purified. They will go to Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَرِضْوَانُ مِنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. If you get all this Jannah and all of what, there are too many details. the best thing in Jannah, when you really get what? The best thing, the greatest. Allah said Akbar. Did you say Allahu Akbar? Wa ridwanu min Allahi Akbar. What's mean Allahu Akbar? Wa ridwanu min Allahi Akbar. The ridwan Akbar min Allah. It means what? The greatest thing in Jannah, to get the pleasure of Allah. If you get the pleasure of Allah, He will never punish you. That's it. This is the best thing. That's why the hadith said, the Ahl al-Jannah, they came, Ya Rab, we still need. We say, what do you need? Didn't I make this for you? Yes. Didn't I take you away from the hellfire? Yes. Didn't I dwell you in Jannah? Yes. What do you need? Ya Rab, we need to see you. We want to see you. And Allah will take the veils away.
Friday?
Yeah. Huh? Every Friday, Sheikh Muhammad, yes. And Allah will take the veils away. You're going to see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the greatest thing in Jannah, not the Jannah itself. No, Jannah is anyway you're going to get it. The pleasure of Allah. If Allah will be happy of you, you get His pleasure, He will never punish you. If you will not be punished, this is what you need. Waradwanu min Allah, this is the greatest. Akbar, Akbar. He said, Waradwanu min Allah, Akbar. And they said, Wadhalika al-fawzu. What is the fawzu al-azim? The success. Some people in dunya, they said the success when I get good business, good wife, good house, good money, good income, whatever. People, they can, I'm healthy, I have a good body, I'm a good looking. And too many people, they can, they are different in this. But the supreme, al-azim, supreme success, when you go to Jannah and you get the pleasure of Allah. I think this is the best thing. How to get this? You have to give the blimbling, inshallah. What's your blimbling? What is the blimbling? فَالْذَلِكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ اُدْخُلُوهَا إِهْ اُدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِمَّا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Yes, because of what you used to do, you will enter Jannah. Now you have to do. You have to give the dowry of the bride. What's your bride? الْجَنَّةِ. And you have to prepare the dowry, otherwise you will not marry. خليك single كده stay ايوه stay single so I have to give the dowry then you're gonna get the bride that's it
what you can do
what Shaykh Muhammad
we have everything over there you don't need nothing over there I don't need you
ماسك بعض طيب يلا نعمل دعاء يلا ان شاء الله جزاك الله اسال الله يا رب ان يوفقنا الى ما يحب ويرضى اسال الله سبحانه وتعالى ان يتقبل منا واياكم صالح الاعمال ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم واغفر لنا فإنك أنت الغفور الرحيم يا ربنا نسألك الجنة بغير حساب ولا سابقة عذاب يا أرحم الراحمين نسألك يا ربنا الفردوس الأعلى مع نبينا والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين يا ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن كان له حق علينا يا أرحم الراحمين استرنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك يا رب العالمين يا ربنا يسر لنا أمورنا يمن لنا كتابنا واحفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا واجعلنا لك من الصالحين يا رب العالمين عبادك المؤمنين اللهم إنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك نسألك خير هذا اليوم وخير ما فيه وخير ما بعده ونعوذ بك يا ربنا من شر هذا اليوم وشر ما فيه وشر ما بعده صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله خيرا.